Now, we all know that Panama is definitely one of the world's top expat destinations. It has its beautiful beaches, its rich biodiversity, and its mountains at your doorstep. It's definitely a retirement haven, especially when it comes to stretching your dollar and the variety you can potentially get from it. You won't need as much money to enjoy a lot of the luxury that's offered, whether you have a pension or not. And I can go on. But enough of the good stuff. You clicked on this vlog to hear about the bad things, the cons, the opposite side of the story, on reasons why you shouldn't retire in Panama, of the less talked about. Now, there's a lot of blogs and vlogs out there talking about how great it is and usually trying to sell you something, but pretending to not be trying to sell you something while explaining how they are actually selling you something, if that makes any sense. All very confusing, but anyways, let's quickly start sharing the 15 downsides of living in Panama, and please buy my... Just kidding. Number 14, internet speed. Now, the internet throughout the country is not even, not even in the separate neighborhoods or streets. And if you want that high speed internet, you'll need to pay prices that are equal to or more than back home. If you choose to live someplace remote, you might not even have internet. You'll need to get satellite internet and pay ridiculous prices for them. So if you're keen in getting the internet, maybe as a digital remote worker, make sure you factor in the cost and budget for it. Number 13, cash society. Yes, the almighty credit card where you can make cash from thin air is available, but there are still many more places that have to use cash, like some grocery stores and some restaurants. It all depends on the place. It seems cash is still the main way to pay for things, and if you do get to pay with a credit card, hopefully it doesn't have any foreign transaction fees. There's the fees at the ATM machines as well with their daily cash withdrawal limits. And you better keep the limits low, or you might have someone looking over your shoulder with a wad of cash. You might even need to pay for your utilities in cash as well every month. But you always need to make sure that cash is always with you and plan out to make sure you make a withdrawal at an ATM machine during the daytime so you don't fear getting mugged. You definitely don't want to walk around carrying a lot of cash. And most places won't accept your $100 bill either. And keep in mind that if you keep using cash, your credit card may become inactive because of the lack of activity as well. But then on the other hand, it's been shown that you might be able to save 30% more money by using cash other than credit card, so it might actually turn out to be a pro instead. Number 12, rains all the time. What's interesting about the rain is that it usually comes right on time. It comes from all directions, from above, obviously from the ground up, and from the side. Anyway, you get the point. It's everywhere. But it happens on time, usually a couple of hours late in the day or early in the morning. But when it does, it pours down a lot, forcing you to adjust your lifestyle. It actually makes you feel like you're being rushed in fear of that first droplet of wetness. So you have to make sure that everything is done in the morning or early afternoon, and you always have to carry your umbrella around as well. And it could be depressing for those that come all the way to Panama expecting a tropical sunshine all the time. While in most cases, yes, it's true, but the heavy rains comes for months at a time and could be depressing. Who wants to live in a place tropical to see it rain all the time? And with the rain comes the humidity as well. Even if you get the rain stopping, the heat and the humidity makes everything wet, never really drying, especially your swimming suit right in the important spots that count. Now, Panama is in the rainforest and receives 60 to 140 inches of rain annually, depending on where you live. Now, that sounds like a lot. And most of the rain comes in heavy 1 to 2 hour downpours late afternoon. Only in October and November will you see rain every day. But of course, there are months where there's no rain at all, the dry season, January to April. It may not rain for a month. Number 11, rules and culture are different. Now, you may be surprised to hear that some of the rules are super strict in Panama, but of course it's not just in Panama. Drinking and driving, as an example, is not tolerated, which of course is a great thing, you might think, to avoid accidents, but back home, you wouldn't be fined, or your car gets impounded, or you get jail time for having a blood alcohol level just a little above 0.0%. So many people just walk around the neighborhood and look for the local bars so they can walk home without driving. You'll find the culture is very different from the US as well, where if you're not willing to follow the philosophy of in Rome, do as the Romans do, you'll find that the systems just don't make any sense. And if you can't adjust when something goes wrong, you may get very frustrated. Number 10, bugs. Now this would be a big one for many. Who wants to see those little guys, sometimes in great numbers, walking through your walls or across your path? Unfortunately, there are bugs everywhere, and the bugs aren't the same as the ones back home. And it's very normal to have bug bites here and there as well. Now it doesn't really bother some, but it could be an issue for others, especially if you don't like the outdoors. You'll find ants in your kitchen, in your bedroom, not only ants, but spiders in your bed, the mosquitoes that may carry a disease you need a shot for. And the only way you can avoid them is to live in a concrete block or live on the 12th floor or above of an apartment to avoid them. Number 9, infrastructure. When you want to take a walk, some areas or a lot of the sidewalks around Panama are in bad shape, big holes, crumbling concrete, and very unleveled. You need to definitely wear sturdy shoes and watch where you are walking all the time. You also get run over if you don't stop because there's no pedestrians have the right-of-way rules in Panama. You'll need to play jumper frog and could be a challenge even at a crosswalk. The trick is go with the pack like an army of fish, they can't run us all over. But the electrical grid and water grid are not in very good shape either. That leads to power outages that everyone expects to happen. Now most of them don't last long, but you'll need to have a bunch of flashlights around just in case. So you see many houses with backup water tanks with pumps to maintain strong water flow, so you'll definitely need one if you buy a home or even a place you're renting. That's the only way to eliminate any water problems for you. And for the electrical problems, you can solve this with battery backups or a generator. Anyways, extra things you have to think about that you don't need to think about back home. And you shouldn't also assume that you'll have hot water at every house or at every faucet in the house either. Some houses only have warm water at the shower. So before moving in, be careful to check out the hot water situation before you decide to rent or buy. Just because it looks good online, you should never rent a house without seeing it first. Number 8, everything moves slowly. It's a super laid-back atmosphere in Panama. You'll be waiting in line a lot, but you'll find that people are pretty patient while you're looking forward at how slow the line is, mentally pounding your fist, thinking that you're spending way more time than you think you should for such a small task. Especially on paydays for the locals, everything gets packed. You'll start developing a superpower and a new skill set in being calm, breathing slowly, saying it's not the end of the world. Number 7, product availability. Now the population of Panama is around 4 million. There isn't a ton of stuff or products to buy. It's a small country and diverse products and brands and stores are not a normality like it is back home. For many of the store owners, they just can't financially afford the latest of stuff unless it's super popular. So what you need to do is you need to switch around your normal items with the local brands, and if you happen to find your brand, it's most likely really expensive. And you'll need to stand there to decide whether it's worth buying. But I guess Amazon is there too, but your order might cost extra per pound. And it might be fun to find those substitutes as well, finding out that there might not be a huge difference in quality, maybe. You'll develop another super skill set in selecting items just as good as the brand stuff. And keep in mind as well that fruits and veggies are more expensive at the grocery store than they are at the local fruit and veggie markets as well. Number 6, buying real estate. This one is probably a big one. Now you always want to rent first before blindly buying a place. Now there's actually people who find a place that looks great online, and once they get there, it's completely different or the neighborhood is questionable. The advertisements online are of course going to make your place look as beautiful as possible using wide-angle lenses and other tricks. You have to be aware of the weather as well. It's different in different areas. More rain here and more sun there. As discussed before, there might be those water problems as well, and that reliable internet you'll need to worry about as well. So you might even get a place that's actually within a resort, so you'll see people, different people, sometimes every day, coming in and out, in and out, feeling like a meat factory, and most people being transient, so good luck making those long-term friendships. Just remember, by renting, you'll be able to get out a lot easier than buying a place, even if you have a permanent residency. Number 5, starting a business. Now some people get tired of their lives back home, totally understandable, and they think of moving to a smaller town or another country with a lower cost of living to start a new life and starting a new business. Now that's a great idea, idea, but only if it's successful. Now, you'll need to obviously do the market research on how competitive your business would be in your new environment, the costs involved, and even whether it's a service even needed. You might be surprised at how much more it would be to open up a business reflected over your overpricing, a price tag no one is going to buy. You also have to make sure everything is in order with your lawyers and local authorities to get the right visas, setting up your business needs as well. I wish the world was as easy as setting up a place with your own two hands one day, then start selling your sugary drinks the next, then getting arrested and next because you found out you needed a visa to work. Number four, parties all the time. Now, if you're looking to retire in a quiet place, it's possible in Panama, but the norm is to party. You'll find that once 9 o'clock comes around, you'll start hearing the drunk people and music going till the early hours of the morning. And yes, there is a thing called earplugs, but it might not be enough. And if you're a morning person that prefers to have that quiet and peaceful start of the day, you might just end up having to want to sleep in with a headache more often than not. But of course, you can always join them if that's your thing. In Rome, do as the Romans do. Number three, speaking Spanish. We all know that Panama is a Spanish-speaking country, but yes, there are large expat communities where you won't even have to speak it and get by. But you'll find that in getting things like your driver's license or even visiting a grocery store or any place that has a potential of small talk, definitely, like being lost, you'll need to know some Spanish. And also if you want those friendships as well with Spanish locals. But there are many Panamanians that are bilingual, so it's much easier for them, but only in the larger cities. Google Translate will be your new best friend, but it's not all that great. You might be in situations where you'll be trapped because while you shop, you'll need to ask what the Google translation translates as well. Conversations are on a way more complex level than a black and white response. And you shouldn't expect Panamanians to speak English either, and it's not their fault that they don't either. You're living in their country, so it's your job to learn at least some of their language. Number two, too much time, not enough money in Panama. Living in that paradise is great, but sometimes in retirement, we end up with way too much time and not enough of that money to spend. You might end up realizing that you've spent away all your life savings, figuring out that your lifestyle was just way too expensive. You're going to have all that free time working so hard to get to this point in life. The cost of shopping, travel, and all the expenses associated with new hobbies could add up. And number one, leaving family and friends. The number one reason would be when you move to another country, you're going to be leaving all your bonds you've made, and for many that could be hard to do. Now, you may not even like them now, but later realize that they are pretty important in your life. And you also need to develop new friendships over time, but it takes time and you start from scratch on new memories. You also realize that you only have one family, although you do have that technology today to connect with your loved ones as well, and to visit maybe once a year. But even moving to another state for some is hard as well. Imagine moving to a whole new country. Well, tell me what you think of the 14 best reasons not to retire to Panama in the comment section below. If you like this vlog, please don't forget to give me a like, subscribe if you haven't already, and hit that notification bell for more of my coming content here. Thank you for watching my vlog. Be free, gain wealth, and travel far.